The Mars orbiter mission was successful last week, and since then there have been so many incredible facts that have come out. It was made in $74 million, that it was cheaper per kilometer than an auto rickshaw, that it was cheaper than what Hollywood took to make a movie about going to space. But one thing that wasn't as popular as it should be is how it was all done. It's brilliant and you should know it. See, India has launched satellites before, but Mars is 100 times further away than the moon. You need an incredible amount of thrust to get it directly from here to there. And the US did that. They made a super powerful launcher that can do the job. Since our satellite was a little lighter than theirs, we tried to do it a little differently. We thought, instead of making a new powerful launcher, we have an old launcher that is not that powerful, but what can we use along with it that is available for cheap that can get us all the way there? We used gravity to make it happen. Because nothing is cheaper than free. Wait, what? We use gravity to get away from the grip of gravity? That's exactly what makes it interesting. So we use something called the interplanetary slingshot to get it all the way there. We use Earth's gravity to gather speed, the sun's gravity to travel, and then Mars's gravity to get closer to it. You beautiful, beautiful people at ISRO. And that's not even the most impressive part. The most impressive part is that the entire program was developed and built right here. Just to put that in perspective, America still uses Russian equipment. Japan tried to build their own and their mission failed. China used Russian equipment and they couldn't get off the launch pad. And young ISRO quietly did it all on its own. India is innovating. It's about time we stop talking about inventing the zeros and Aryabhatta and Vedas. India is innovating now and you should know about it. As we speak, there are laboratories in India where there's heavy research going on in nuclear technology. We're trying to find a way to use thorium, which is abundantly more available than uranium, as an energy source. The number of papers we've submitted on this is twice as much as any other country. And we even have a plant that's scheduled to come up in 2016. That is huge because India has the highest reserves of thorium in the world. Our energy problems could be solved forever. India is innovating. They say Indians are only good at managerial jobs and dog work. So these two guys went to find out if that was true. They went to talk to heads of innovations of major companies like Google, Microsoft, and Intel to ask them if this was true. As it turns out, these heads of innovations were Indians, not people of Indian origin, people who came through the same rote education system here. India is innovating. 750 multinational companies have set up their research and development offices in India. Research and development, the core of their innovation, not call centers, not data feeding, research and development. IBM has 70,000 Americans and 150,000 Indians. The number of usable patents India puts out is as much as any other country. Flights can land in zero visibility and fly without collision because of Indian patents. India is innovating. There is so much innovation happening and it's just the beginning. We can do so much more. We need to stop being engineering graduates and be engineers. Engineer something. We need to stop being drafting experts and be designers. Make something. We need to stop making the aim of our lives to settle down and look to steer something up. See, when you say India is not innovating, we're not talking about the soil, the land, or the territory. India in that sentence is the people. That's you and me. So we're taking the first step. We're building a platform for innovators. We've made a page called the Makers of Things, where on a regular basis, we're looking to find and feature innovators throughout India. If you are someone who's made something interesting or know someone who's made something interesting, big, small, silly, anything, let us know so we can feature it. Right now, make sure you go to that page and make sure you make it show in your news feeds. So when people do come to talk about their innovations, let's make sure they have an audience. Actors and sportspersons have always been celebrities. For a while, let's try to make a new kind of celebrity. The inventors, the dreamers, the makers of things that keep us evolving.